ginger warrior. I can tell you a few stories about this lad.
We'd all love to hear.
Yeah. Off to nine ball for 2 or 3 years. Seen the light, back to the IPO.
It's the way forward, one of them big ball games.
Reds and yellows for Scotty.
Gets complicated, spots and scrapses.
Yeah, he's not the cleverest. It's nice and easy for him now. All these road maps.
Anyway, welcome to this IPA Pro Event quarter-final between Scott and Jason. Should be a decent game.
Yeah, it promises to be a great match, this. Both playing at the top of the game at the moment. After all these years, Jason's really hit top form again. And Scott is just about back where he wants to be. And he's knocking on the door for a big win for sure.
Yeah, he shot up the rankings, hasn't he? He's like started making like quarters and semis regular and all the pros and stuff.
Yeah, last tour in Bradford, I think he lost to Clinton Nyhansen in the semi at the pro event. He was in front, lost the last three frames, but that's the way it goes in this game, you know. You get one shot and you're in. If you don't, you're out. Top of the top, yeah, you're right, yeah. Oh, Jason's won the leg. See his big break. He's been doing this for a few years, hasn't he?
He certainly has. It's far better than my break, anyway.
Yeah, well, he's had, a couple of world titles?
Yeah, I think he's got 3 world titles.
Going back 20 years.
Yeah,
just won the Lifetime Achievement Award, was it? That's the Bradford.
Yeah, fantastic achievement that was. Got a standing ovation and everything.
Yeah, standing ovation. It was great to see, because he's a great fella, Jason, as well.
Yeah, he's deserved it. He's put a lot into the sport.
Right, we're off.
He's just got the 1 awkward yellow here. Probably even the 1 awkward red as well.
Well, he will look awkward to me. Looking like a yellow, doesn't it? The yellow starter.
Yeah, he looks like he's going to go yellows, but I'm not quite sure if the ball at the top end of the table passes. Even if it doesn't, he can run off the ball that's now over the middle. Be able to just play like a slow roll cannon and it opens up the frame for him.
Yeah, he's played that well. He's got himself some options now. And I'm sure we'll find him running around the table now, methodically, like he does.
Player with Jason standard probably get these. But never know.
I'll tell you what, he's going to need to get these, because them reds ain't looking too bad either.
No,
and Scott is ready to take them out.
He brought well off the break, really. I mean, he's got one. He's got like one half decent shot, and he'll be alright, yeah.
Yeah, for sure. Jason taking his time here, because he knows one miss here, and the first frame's gone. But it's a big match, isn't it? You know, they're both knocking on the door to come back into the top form of their lives, and I think you could get the winner out of these two quite easily, couldn't you?
Yeah, it wouldn't surprise me. Either of these two guys went in the tournament night, and plus there's decent money up for grabs as well, so that's, you know, it's always nice to get off to a decent start and try and...
Yeah, what is the top prize now? Being Scott's backer, I should know, but I'll try not to think about it too much. I don't want to put any pressure on him. The first prize, I think, is getting up there, isn't it?
I think three grand, maybe a couple of 2.5.
2,500, I think you're right. It's a nice payday, isn't it?
Yeah, it's not bad for a day's work, is it?
Happy days.
So looks like he's just going to play the cannon now, and then he should open the frame up. Oh, wow. He's missed it.
Wow. Well, you would put your money on Jason getting that ball in the middle, opening the red and the yellow up and finishing there, wouldn't you? All day long.
Yeah, he's not got away with it, but he's sort of left Scott like a bit awkward here. I think he'll just play the bank shot and then just like try and cover the hole.
Yeah, I'm sure you're right. Scott's got no problem with pressure. He'll be doing the right thing for sure.
Left the pocket a bit open, but that's not too bad.
I'm gonna edge on Jason getting these. I think on the screens it may look a little bit tighter than it actually is. If he makes the cannon there, I think that yellow will sneak through. If he gets the right angle there, he's playing the cannon on the other top corner.
Yeah, it does actually. It does look tight on the screens though, but clearly it does pass. So again, it's just a case of one good shot really.
Yeah, that's right. We'll see what he does here. So he can leave himself a little angle off this this yellow he's looking at now.
Dangerous though, if he does play this and leave the angle and then he cannons into it and pots it, he might not be on the other yellow.
Yeah, you could. I mean, you could play this shot, get it right. The other yellow could go in, he could be snookered, but, you know, these top players, they make their own luck, don't they? Not like me.
If he plays this well, he deserves a little bit of luck to be on the other ball.
Oh, for sure.
That's not very good for
him. Well, surprised me there, to be honest, but, you know, the skill shot's on. We're playing in Glasgow, and you'll find all these Scottish lads up here, they're well used to playing these skill shots. For us English boys, it's quite new to our game, isn't it?
It is, yeah. It takes a while to adjust them, where you can play them from and how you're playing them, really, but they're not too bad when you get the angle.
They're not too bad, but you're sort of getting into these missions, you're thinking, oh, do I really want to take this on? But sometimes the shot's there to be taken, isn't it? And you've got to take it ball by the horns and get on with it, haven't you?
This doesn't really look massively on, but it's a tough one, soft angle as well. Oh, he tried to go around the back of it, wow.
Yeah, he's looked like he's gone around the back of that and not quite made it. So Scott Higgins is back in with another chance, and maybe the first shot's there to pot and kick that bad red out and could be all over.
That's a good shot. Just needs the white to pull up a little bit. And there we go.
Yeah, that's perfect. He'll be happy with that.
Got these fat last five balls to pot now. It should be one there. Can't really see him missing from here, but
not as planned, I don't think, but that'll do. It's always going to be on, wasn't it?
Too much trouble barring an absolute disaster, was he? I think the only way he wasn't going to be anything if he's stuck on the red or something.
No, absolutely right. Barring a glaring mistake here, it's two plops in the black for 1-0 to Scott Higgins. Fairly simple black into the corner. 1-0, Mr. Higgins.
And he's got the break as well.
He'll be praying for a decent break, maybe a dish now. And getting a cushion of two frames is massive in a game like this, especially against someone like Jason, who's just let him in. And he's been punished, and that's so important in this game, isn't it, to punish your opposition.
Yeah, especially if you get a couple of frames lead, it's a thing you know you can afford to maybe miss one. And, you know, the other guy knows he can't afford to miss anything.
Yeah, absolutely. So here we go then. Scott, he's got a big break, Scott, as well. Yeah. Put their muscles to use here.
Bit of an action man, isn't he? Thank you.
has an awesome break, and he's been so unlucky there. He won't be happy with that. Face is screwed up. He's not happy with that, and you can't blame him. That's
again, though, it's not the easiest run out from here, I think.
I think he'd rather beat the table, didn't he?
Yeah, he'd sooner attack this table, but he's not left it. He's got a couple of good shots he'll have to play on either set.
Yeah, he's got the options here. You can take, obviously, in this game, you can take the yellow, pot of red. You know, you've got an open table now. You can basically any colour you want to carry on the game.
I think I'd be going reds and trying to put the white just next to the red that's at the bottom end of the table, and then playing the other red off the yellow that's over the pocket, and that'll just like open the game up. But he looks like he's going to take yellows.
Yeah, I'm with you. You take the plant at the bottom and get the red going, but he's obviously going. He's obviously he's looking at it differently. But the guy's a multiple world champion, and this is what it's all about. He knows exactly what he's doing.
I think I've just missed something there. Like.
It went in a bit quick, didn't it? But anyway, reds it is. He's got the red that was behind the red and yellow, if you like. And all of a sudden,
looks a really good chance.
Little three ball plant are we looking at?
Yeah, he's going to play it. You don't really need to play this, but it's an option.
Jason is always all in, you know that.
He's sort of
and now he's back exactly where he was.
Yeah. He didn't really need to play that. The balls went anyway. It was just a case of playing a good positional shot.
Yeah, so a little bit more thought now.
He can still drop in behind that ball next to the yellow, though. It's not like it's in the worst position. He just needs a decent angle on the ball to get down onto it.
No, absolutely. What he doesn't want to do is break down here and give Scott the chance to come back and punish him again. That would really hurt Jason.
Because he's had good chances in both frames, hasn't he? So.
Yeah, absolutely. And he won't be forgiving of himself for that. He'll be wanting to take this out by hook or crook, or playing a quality safety shot.
Looks like he's got the angle now to play onto it.
There you go. No, Jason, he does like going for it, doesn't he? He's always there. Maybe you can play this down, just drop on that red. It's I don't know. He's got a couple of options, hasn't he?
Yeah, I think he'd probably opt to try and drop on it now and then. It opens the frame up, and it's well. To be honest, he should get this from here. Just when he's one half decent shot, like. Yeah, there you go. Perfect.
Yeah, that's absolutely perfect. Nice little angle, just about to stand back up. Yeah, no rushing around for Jason. He's going to make sure of this.
A little bit trickier now. He's got enough space to go into. He's got a couple of balls there that he could possibly fall behind if he plays it wrong.
A little bit of traffic there, like I say, but you've seen where he's just put his cue. He wants to just plop this in, tad a left hand side, and nip round that yellow by the well. Perfect.
That's a shot. Squared it up. Big frame from that after the way he lost the first one.
Yeah, Jason will be happy with that. Got him back on an even keel because he looked like he could have broke down there, but that's Jason.
Long way to go though in a race to nine.
Yeah, 1-1, first to nine for the semi. This is the quarter final, isn't it? So it is a long way to go, and you can be sure this will be a great match all the way through. They won't be letting up on each other at all.
A few dishes. Hopefully, loads of good attacking pool. It's always nice.
Guaranteed, I'd say. So the Tornado's winded himself up. Another big break. Hold on tight. Desperately unlucky.
That looks like throw him away, to be honest. It's a monster break.
Yeah, it's a fantastic break. Couple of yellows down there, red. It's leaving Scott with a free table, a free shot. And I don't think these yellows will be there for too long, eh?
No, he's just probably play the red on the left hand side of the table and just leave himself on his. There's only slightly awkward ball that goes into like one or two pockets. And he's
be looking at 2-1 very quickly.
I do find in these situations well, sometimes people overcomplicate things. They look for something to more go wrong. And they've got they want to use the free shot in a way that they see is productive, but sometimes you're just best getting down and getting on with it.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, like I say, you can only really see one problem ball here. I'm sure you're right though. I'm sure he'll tap out and he'll leave himself a roadmap. I think he's looking at playing the black onto the yellow. Tapping it down. He's got options here. Obviously, all the balls where he is at the bulk end, you know, they're not really that any of them are problems, but it's just getting that first shot right, and it's easy to get this first shot wrong, and all of a sudden you've got problems and you're chasing your tail, aren't you?
Yeah, I just think he plays the ball on the left-hand side of the table, puts himself in the ball in the middle of the table. I think from there, I don't think too much that can go wrong, you know. Yeah, he's going to play that way. Yeah, he can even get on the ball now next to the block after the shot, and then, you know, it looks pretty simple.
He's just about on this yellow below the black now, so he'll be playing this out, screwing this ball out somewhere around the middle of the table or just above the middle of the table, and you can't see any problems. That'll do him. Maybe a bit shorter than he wanted, but it looks good. Played that well. He's played that very well. Barring any mistakes now. 2-1 to Scott.
Yeah, he's took these with ease on, he made them look easy.
Yeah, and for any of you out there watching, this is the way to do it. Make sure of that first shot, get it right. And it makes the whole game easy. Simplest of blacks for Scott, and he jumps into a 2-1 lead over Jason, and again he's taking the frame away from Jason.
Yeah, big break from Jason. To be fair, the white was unlucky to go enough because it did travel a bit, but he kind of did lose it. Normally stops it quite dead.
Yeah, he was dead unlucky there really, because it's shot round the table, found the corner pocket, but he's stolen it off Jason. So again, he's got the chance here to break and take control of the frame and try and get that 2-frame cushion, which is obviously massive in this game. It's like tennis, isn't it? You're trying to break the serve and get in front and try and keep it.
Yeah, it's a big weapon, because if you're in front, and it's like anything, you can afford to make one mistake, so you know you're not going to be behind. But chasing a game is so hard, especially at this level.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, these guys have both got massive breaks, and they've both got so much knowledge of the game. You know, it's one shot pull most of the time. And there you go. He's broke. He's made a ball.
Yellow's all the set if he can just play this.
Yeah, yellow's with his friends again here. And I think his first shot, he's probably got a chance to free it, has he not?
Yeah, he definitely has. He looks a bit tight on the camera angle, but yeah, he's...
I I think he can make this in the corner.
I don't think Red's it up either. I think he can actually hold the red into the centre.
There's one ball for each being held up by the other, isn't there?
Yeah, I think he's just going to roll this in. Oh. Yeah, you can just play the cannon now.
Yeah, same difference now. He's gone reds, but it was all about those two balls down on the right-hand side there.
See, he's got a decent angle.
Yeah, you can see it there. It's perfect. He's going to take this frame out. I can't see this going wrong for him. Perfect, huh? Maybe a little bit tighter than he would like the angle, but if he can get himself to get the opposite middle down the rail and back up the two at the top of the table,
yeah,
looks game over.
If he does have to play it thin, he's got the gap between the two yellows. It's quite a big target, really, to get in between. But if he doesn't fancy playing it now, it's not a disaster. He can just like take it the other way.
Yeah, no, he's taking the safe route, to be fair, and he's... Has he just found the angle where he's...
Landed a bit straight onto
yeah,
himself.
He's come out a little... Definitely come out a little bit straight there, but... He'll collect himself here. Gather his thoughts. Get the right shot in his head.
Yeah, the balls are still in the open. They're there to be taught. Just got to take them right the right way and just... Probably play one good shot, maybe. Maybe only an half-decent one, but... I'd fancy him take these all day.
I fancy I'd take these all day. But then again, my twitch is bigger than this.
Both players probably playing a little bit slower than what they do normally. It's because it's such a big game. Maybe just both want to like establish yourself into the game.
Yeah, they're both looking for that title, aren't they? I mean, they're both, like we said earlier, they're both knocking on the door of getting another decent title under their belts, and there's a few quid rolling on it now, so it is a big game because they both respect each other's games, obviously, massively, and, you know, one mistake, and it, as it's been shown in the first three frames, there's been one mistake and the other one's taken it.
He's got a play in between the gap now, between the yellow and the black. It looks like he's going to play with quite a bit of side. He would have wanted this a bit easier, I think.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, this can go wrong. He has got into that, but, you know, he's got a solid cue action. He can use side better than most people you'll see in this game. He'll find this, I'm sure. He'd be unlucky if he doesn't. There's a few gaps to get there, you know. It will work out. Maybe he'll just screw around the two, three cushions, come back behind the black, or...
Yeah, the angle, I don't know about the screw. I think he will opt to just like play with like running side and just
push it running side it through. Yeah, he's got that. Yeah,
he would have to be unlucky. There's only probably the black that can hinder him. Like,
I just don't think he likes that shot.
No,
I know exactly what you're saying. He's looking at that black, thinking, "Am I going to fall behind that black?"
He's going to have to play this quite slow as well. Like quite a bit of drag. There's always a danger that the ball can just like sort of.
There you go, he's just looked exactly what we were saying, the shot that you've obviously come up with, and he's looked at the black, so maybe he will cannon it. There you go, there's the cannon.
He's on it, yeah.
He's just about got through, but there you see, that's what he was worried about. Just rolling up behind that black, and it could have put him in prison, that, couldn't it?
Yeah, that wouldn't have been nice at all, would it? It's pretty much perfect now, I just want
to... He's on this absolutely... Perfect, like you say. One good shot here. Screw back a little bit. Ball in the top opposite corner. Job's a good one for 3-1.
Oh,
he's proper got into that.
I don't think that goes in the middle either.
No, it doesn't. He's still got a play in the top corner.
I think this frame would hurt him as well because he's had a real good look at these, like, you know, and that shot there just could cost him.
Yeah. There's a rush of blood there, sure.
Maybe just a bit of tension in the arm.
Definitely. He knows that cushion's there. What a great shot. That's why these players are so good, isn't it? I mean, we all get ourselves into trouble like that. And, you know, it's so easy to take it to heart and miss the shot. And
yeah, they get themselves out of trouble, don't they?
Yeah, they look at it, they assess it, and they get down, and they get it right, and bang, it's in. Great shot. And there's his pillar. There's his two frames. He'll be happy with that. Even though he won't be happy with what he's done, he'll be happy with that.
Just puts a bit of pressure on Jason now. He's got to sort of get not back in the game because he's not really out of it, but he needs to stay older, Scotty, because he can't let him go 3-4 frames up.
No, definitely not. Scott's been playing so well. I mean, he played his two games yesterday in the first two rounds. And he was good. I mean, very, very solid. Maybe two mistakes in each match, if that.
Is this Scott's first year as a professional, is it, or is it his second? He's lost a white ball there, and...
Oh, Jason, he's had such a nightmare with the break. That's two breaks on the trot now. Look, he's lost the white, eh?
Yeah, he's... That was a poor break, though, because he just went straight enough. He's... Sometimes you can be unlucky, but if you're going straight enough, then it's a poor shot, really, isn't it?
Yeah, it's Scott's second year as a pro, yeah. I think he was in the last pro event from last year. I think he beat Kev Barton in the quarter final and lost in the semi again, so he's still knocking on that door.
Obviously, like your first year is the learning curve as well, so you know, the more experience you get under your belt playing the top players, the more you improve as well. Like.
Oh yeah, definitely. I mean, there's some great amateurs in this game as well, you know, and the professionals are obviously a cut above, you know, and there's some of the guys that are playing on this, I mean, they are the greatest players in this game, and you come across any of these players, you need to be able to take these frames out in one.
Yeah, I think anyone who's sort of like lingering at like the 64-32 mark, I think you want to be taking the pro status, because I think it helps when you do play against quality players all the time. It sort of gets you used to doing it.
Yeah, absolutely. Do you find that the top players sort of go for it more than you'd expect, or maybe more than the amateurs? You find the games are quicker. Is that down to not just that they're better, but because they are more attacking, more aggressive?
I think it varies on like different players. I think like I see a few boys like Marshy and Simon Ward, and they sort of go for a lot more than what you'd expect, and most of the time they get it as well.
Absolutely. Now you see Scott has just pulled in the reins there. He knows he's got Jason on the coals, so he's played the right shot there. He's obviously not gone all in. He's going to let Jason open the black up a bit more maybe for him.
There's not a lot Jason can do with this. He's sort of he's a bit knackered, really, I'm being honest.
Yeah, it's a good safety shot that, because obviously he's got the two balls in the middle of the table, and they're not really terrible. He can always get on that, but yeah, Jason's got problems here.
I think if the ball in the middle of the table does go, then I think Scott's about a 10s on favourite, but if it doesn't go, then he's got a little bit of work to do. Maybe he might look at trying to play cushion first.
You know, watching Jason over the years, he comes up with shots that people just don't even think of, don't they? You know, he's got himself out of so many scrapes over the years, but looks like he's just going for a little tap out. And he's tried to tie it up tight. It's not the worst shot in the world. It's not easy either for Scott here.
I mean, just left him awkward on the bridge and like.
Yeah, so. See, that's a great shot from Jason, really. I mean, you couldn't have got too much better than that.
A lot of times, well, sometimes when you're in a position like that, where you think, oh, my back's up against the wall, you know, some players just go for something, whereas I think Jason always makes you work to take
the frame. That is the difference, isn't it? You know, the difference between the great players and the amateur players that want to get to where these guys like this are. And you can see there from Jason that he didn't give in. He knuckled down. He found a spot for the white. He's put it in there. And Scott's had nothing really, apart from a bit of a run out of shot, and you know, give it back to Jason again.
Well, that's it now. He brings his ball off the cushion here, and he's going to force Scott to play either a very good pot or a very good safety shot. And you know, the Reds are not exactly ungettable, are they? So they could be right back in the frame. If
no, absolutely right. And you wouldn't put nothing past Jason Twist. He's a time-served professional and one of the greatest guys you'll ever meet. He puts his time and effort into this game, even now after 20-odd years.
That's a bit lapsed there. I think if you can just drop this in and leave the white where the yellow is, you can play the cannon into the red and the yellow off the one from the middle. He's going to play now, actually.
Yeah, this cannon comes out nice.
Oh, that's been a bit unkind.
It hasn't come out great, but he's got options, obviously. He's got a chance.
Yeah, he's got one good shot bridge, I think. Unless he decides to play the one in the middle, which I think the tougher pot, obviously, is the one where you're bridging, but it's all right, you can get this in the middle.
Well, there you go. So now it's just down to Scott Ian, he's queuing. Can he take these last three yellows out, land back on the black, and go another one clear? Yeah. It's warming up to be a great game, but Jason's just having... Oh, his main problem has been the break. He's not really getting much of a look in from that, is he?
No, the last few frames he's had nothing really to go at. It's a bit careless there from Scott. He's got to play a decent shot now for like two cushions. Just run it round. No, he's got quite a bit of space, but there's like one or two obstacle balls there.
That's it. As long as he avoids that red that he was just queuing by there, he can whip round off of one, two, or even three. And I can't really see him being in too much problems here. Oh, just got by it, just hit the knuckle, but you know, Jason's going to be spewing there because he's basically just got to stun this. Black's gone, 4-1.
It's a big lead as well. He's virtually halfway there now, and he's free clear. Jason's got to keep hold of him here, otherwise it could get a bit serious.
Yeah, he's had a dream start here, hasn't he, Scotty? Yeah, he's absolutely perfect on the black. He's had a dream start here. He's been given at least two of these frames. So here we go.
I'm already given the frame.
I'm glad that went in. Rather you than me. So there we go, Scott Higgins, 4-1 in front of Jason Twist. I don't think we would have predicted that to start with, did you?
I didn't fancy either player to run away. I thought it'd be a close game. But
yeah, exactly. You'd be thinking maybe one or two frames cushion, but there you go.
Still enough time for Jason to get back into it, but I think he needs to start doing something now rather than...
Yeah, Jason's well capable of running for three, four, five racks. You know, once you get his thing on, he's away. He can be away, and you won't know what's happened.
I think maybe 6-1. I think would be I think too big of a deficit for anyone against Scott. I think he needs to just start, maybe claw a couple back now. At least two out of the next three, I think he needs to win.
There you go, another monster break from Scott Higgins, and
again, he's only got one problem ball, hasn't he?
Again, one problem ball. As he navigates himself around that, pops it out. I think these reds would be good night.
Yeah, he's got. I think he can screw into the two balls there now off the first shot from the ball over the bag.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think he'll just take his time, sort out his route here, and. Well, it's all down to the first shot again. So obviously, the first shot is massive every time, isn't it?
Yeah, especially in blackball because it's if you miss, it's still open table. It defines which route you go and everything else. Yeah, there, it's a great shot.
There it is. And how well's that come out for him? He's not going to be unhappy with that, is he?
No, he won't take that back, would he?
All day, thank you very much. And he's been blessed in this. Seventh frame, sixth frame is the great break again. Jason must be thinking, why can't my breaks come out like that?
You know, he's not been to the table, has he, in the last sort of three frames of him?
No, he's definitely been under the cosh, but Scotty's got to make hay while the sun shines here, and he knows that. You know, he knows how strong Jason is. He knows that he can come back at him any time. So he'll be taking every effort here to get this right. You know, the 5-1 lead, that's going into a 6-1 lead, massive.
If you don't make things work when things are going well for you, then how do you expect to do it when they're not going for you?
It's got to exactly right. It's a great setting here, isn't it? This lovely weather here at the Erskine Bridge Hotel.
Oh, it's superb. It's like out in the countryside. It's stunning views.
In between games, they're all outside on the lawn, overlooking the River Clyde, I think it is out there. It's sponsored by Compass Cars, as you can see. Local company and local taxi company here in Glasgow.
The IPA's moved forward massively in the last couple of years from where it started, you know.
Definitely. I mean, I've been on the IPA myself since 1997, almost as long as Jason. Been around a long time, and I've seen everything in the game, and I've got to say that it's a joy to be on these days. You know, it's and over the next few years, I think the players are just going to flood in. There's a lot of new players coming in, and there's a lot of good talent out there, and there's a lot of players that have come through leaps and bounds in the last few years as well. A lot of new blood.
Yeah, there's a few of the Welsh boys that, to be honest, from playing World Rules, I've never really heard of, and so you come on here and you see players that you think, oh, I've not heard them. Normally you think you'd be all right when you draw them, but there's a lot of players that you just, unheard of, really. And they're
well-established players, aren't they? I mean, they've got on the tour, they're coming in, they're making a name for themselves straight away, and there's quite a few of them out there.
Yeah, it's surprising. I mean, Black Ball's really growing, you know, with the county setup and everything else. It's really taking off.
Yeah, the EBPF and the county and the Black Ball is massive, isn't it? It's we just had the finals, it was in January down at Selsey, and you know, I was there myself, and it was a great setting. It was great. All the lads that you don't see from one year to the next, all together, and a great event and put on by a great organisation. And there you go. Scott Higgins 5-1, and he's got to be enjoying this.
Yeah, he's on his steamrolling at the minute, isn't he? He's on fire. Yeah, I've not actually been to Selsey myself, but I've heard it's very good. It's
well, I love Selsey because it's in the south where I'm from. having to travel up to Yarmouth for all those years was always a mission. But yeah, Selsey, it's lovely place. A really nice place, really, really well run, and it is worth getting through on those county games, and it is worth getting there because there's a lot of players out there now that, like we said, are just coming into it, and you've got all these new guys coming through for the England team, and they're all coming out of this Black Ball Federation, you know.
Yeah, it's really taking off. It's like even Rill's another one. I mean, I've heard about it and stuff like that, and not been there, but I'm going to go this year for the Super Freeze, which should be a top event, really.
Yeah, I should be there myself, looking after the tables, so I'm looking forward to that. Not been to Real myself either, but another great event in another new place. Yeah, the World Championships this year at Lakeside, weren't they?
It was superb. Like, the venue there was unreal.
Yeah, I mean, obviously Lakeside's, you know, synonymous with the darts and whatever, but it's a great arena for any those sort of sports, you know. And it was good to see everyone there and enjoying it.
Yeah, it was well worth the money to enter. It was decent to go and play at such a prestigious event, and you know, hopefully that's the first of many World Championships at the Lakeside for it, you know, and hopefully the crowds keep coming and the game keeps on growing.
Yeah, that's what we want. Get the crowds in, watch this game. I mean, this game of ours has been around for such a long time, and it's in all your pubs and clubs, every town and city in the country. And I think it's just starting to really get out there now. It's starting to grow. With the live streaming and everything else now, everybody can see it, you know, and everybody wants a little go, don't they?
That's it, yeah. The more people see it, hopefully, the more they enjoy it and keep watching, really. I think it still probably needs a little bit of razzmatazz to it, you know, a bit of touching up, but yeah, it's definitely going the right way. The game's in a, well, Black Ball's in a far better state than what it was maybe 3-4 years ago, the IPA took it onto a new level.
Yep, that's Paul in general, and the IPA is going to be leading the pack, and they're definitely doing the right things and getting out there and getting the sponsors and the money behind it, and it won't be long before we see it really take off. And in the meantime, Twisty's got back to the table.
Yeah, he's got a routine finish here to go 5-2. It's a massive frame, really. He needs this one.
Yeah, he can't afford to let this go.
Especially with the way Scott's playing, he's not really missing anything, so he needs to be taking these sort of chances all the time.
That is unbelievable. Maybe, you know, like you say, there's a bit of pressure out there. You know, he really, really needs to take that frame, and I think his elbows give up on him there.
Yeah, is it? I don't know. You don't normally see Jason miss balls out, but I suppose when you're 5-1 down, it's hard, you know, because you've got every shot's a bit of pressure on it.
Definitely. I mean, that is a shock to see Jason miss that ball.
If Scott does take these out, I think this will hurt Jason massively.
Oh, Jason will be disgraced with himself there. He, you know, all day long he's going to take that game out. You could put your house on it, Norman, couldn't you?
Yeah, I would have had quite a bit of money on that, actually. But someone have offered me an even bet.
Well, anyway, back to Scott. The man of the moment in this game is... He's really knuckling down, and, you know, he's got his game face on there. He knows that if he takes this, it's going to hurt Jason badly. He needs to pull up.
As well.
Yeah, no, he's fine. He's good.
He looked like he was just going to sit on it, wasn't he? I can't believe what I've just witnessed. Kev Barton has actually put his hand in his pocket to buy a pint.
Hold on a minute, I've got to drink some of it before he comes and takes it away.
You heard it here first, a Yorkshireman has bought a pint.
And not any Yorkshireman.
I'll take on the double A if he gets this. This is a massive chance. He's got it as well.
Oh, yes, God, that's another great shot. You know, he's taking the ball by the horns, isn't he?
Yeah, this is a great take. This wasn't the easiest finish. He had to play these the right way. No, he's just got one good shot to get around the back of this red. And
nice controlled shot here. Just a stun screw behind this red. Same pocket.
Little touch hard.
Yeah, touch hard, but...
He's all right.
He's okay.
Can use the side rail a bit here to just... He's a bit of pace, he can run up, he can, this shot's not too bad, he can go too far even, it's not. Yeah, that's alright, that is.
How well has he played that? Yeah. He's played that very well. That's good cueing for you, is that? Straight away. Bit of pressure on that shot, because this is a massive lead coming in. And there it is, 6-1, Scott Higgins.
Scott's not missing here. This is going to be really tough for Jason to turn round. He needs to win like 8 out of the next 10 frames. It's a big ask against anyone, but Scott in this sort of form especially.
That's almost lottery numbers, isn't it? Like I say, Scott's playing top game at the moment. Well, Jason has been as well, but you know, being fair to Jason, he really hasn't got in, and that's where the problems have come from. He's just not enough table time, has he?
No, he's never got. He's never, apart from that last frame there, which he should have took, I think that's the only thing in the match he's really done wrong. But the important thing is, though, that Scott is punished every time Jason does make a mistake, he's punishing him. And if he's going to keep punishing him, it's going to be hard for Jason to win.
Well, let's see how this break goes. Another big crunch of the balls from Scott Higgins.
They didn't quite separate as I thought they would. The yells here are just absolute.
I'd like to say dollies, but. At the moment, Jason's obviously feeling a little bit here, so you can be sure he's going to go for the yellows.
Too bad.
No, the reds aren't too bad. I think the start is probably a little bit easier on the yellows, is it?
This could push it awkward, though. If he does play the ball in the middle off the red, then it could push it over the top right on pocket and make the finish a bit tougher, then, I think.
I still think he's going yellows there.
Yeah, I think he will do, but he's just got to play this quite then
is the plant a good first shot? I think it opens everything up properly, doesn't it?
Yeah.
But would you want to take it?
I think I'd be tempted to take reds, yeah.
The choice is there. It's how you see it, isn't it? I mean, we're looking at it and think, you know, it's easy when you're not playing, isn't it? It's one of those.
Yeah. It always looks a bit easy, doesn't it?
But,
I think I play the one closest to the bottom rail and go up for the one on the side cushion. I think you've just got four or five balls in the middle of the table that he takes every day of the week, but it looks like he might go yellows.
You still can't tell, can you? He's looking at the plant. He wants to take the plant because he knows it offers him the chance.
Yeah, this
just
opens
finish.
Up. But this is definitely missable. There's a lot of distance between them.
Without doubt.
He might just secure his colour here and then play the plant. Because if he does that, then he's going
to
kill it.
There you go. The plant's coming in. This needs to go.
Yeah, that's a good shot.
Yeah, he's exactly where he wanted. You see him queuing up before that shot for this ball, so he can run through, take the other ball at the top, and work his way down to his second frame.
It's a bit of a risky first shot, though. You know, you've got to commend them on taking that, because if he'd have got that wrong, it could quite easily have been 7-1.
Yeah, Jason's not one for being scared of a shot. He's won titles on shots like that. He sees it. The way he wants to take it, and that's him. As long as his elbow doesn't seize up again, but I think he's oiled it now, so.
You'd hope so, wouldn't you?
Yeah, he's going to take these out. I'm going to go all out like you did. I'm going to say 6-2, Scott Higgins.
Yeah, you can't see him missing here. He'd have to do something, but I don't know how he could.
We didn't know he could miss the last one, but he did.
Yeah.
But let's not. So anything to make that happen. We want to see him get out of these.
That's perfect.
Played it well, yeah. So a little soft screw into the red, or even past the red. Let's have a look.
Yeah, he's got loads of room there.
Yeah, he can do what he likes here.
The ball passes the black. Everything's
barring glaring mistakes. Jason will, in fact, put his second game on the board, and he'll feel a lot better because 7-1. You need to put your cue away.
Yeah, it's a massive frame. You need to get a bit of a roll going now and just get a couple. But you know, he's still in there, still fighting away.
Yeah, well done, Jason Twist. You know, he was under the gun there. He knows he's made a glaring mistake before, and he's taken him out well. You know, he's found his first shot. He knows what he wants to do.
I've got a bit of way to ease in that as well.
Yeah.
When you make a mistake as well, it's important that you do recover quick.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. And he knows he's gone the way he wanted to go. That's the thing. And in his head now, he'll he'd have forgot all them mistakes now. He's got his frame on the board. And now he just wants to get a big break here without the white going in.
Yeah, 6-3, be right back in the match, you know. So this is a big couple of frames for Jason here. I think he probably needs to win both of them, you know. He can't afford to stay four frames behind all the way through the match. He needs to start acting now and start getting, start clawing Scott back.
Keep the white on the table, Jace.
He has done. What, has he made a vault? Don't think he has. No. And oh my, the yellows are.
You know what, this could drive you to drink, and he's obviously thinking.
It's a cruel game at times, isn't it?
I've kept the white out, I've done everything right. And look at them, they've split up.
I can just see that the fact that there's like.
Scott must
six balls in the rough the table.
Scott must be thinking Christmas has come early. Christmas is in June.
Yeah, that's perfect. That should be 7-2 now. Scott's looking good, you know. If this keeps happening off Jason's right, then Jason's definitely not going to find a way into the match.
No, it's definitely another gift, isn't it? I mean,
yeah.
he's had the run of the ball, Scott, for sure.
I mean, he's had three glaring chances off Jason's break, you know. I think it's a massive part of the game, right? You know, it just shows that how important it is. If someone's breaking like that and they're leaving you chances like this all the time, then I think anyone on the IPA tour can be steer-rolling someone, you know.
Yeah, well, I can break like that and get the balls open like that and pot a ball, but then I'll miss one over the pocket. These boys ain't doing that, are they?
I don't think I've seen Scott miss a ball in the match, actually. He's been he's been really good.
If Scott's going to miss it, he's not going to go for it. He's going to find another shot, and that's where his game has come on so much this year. Same coming out of the nine ball a few years ago, 3 years ago, he's now fully dedicated to the IPA and to, oh, we say that, and it's hung. He's just caught the inside jaw, isn't he? Just trying to drag it through there.
Yeah, this is big as well, because the skill shot's quite easy from where the yellow is, and he's just got the problem three balls like that are in a bit of a cluster, but maybe one good double there, and this could be Jason's way back into the match.
Yeah, I mean it's not a glaring mistake. I think it's a little bit unfortunate. I mean the pockets are not massive or anything like that, but he has just caught that inside jaw.
Yeah, you would have fancied his part sort of ball though, wouldn't you? I mean he's not missed anything throughout the match.
No, that's his first miss, and
just proves he's human, doesn't it?
Yeah, there you go. You know, he'll be upset with himself because he knows it was a 7-2 lead. So we'll have to see how Jason builds on this.
He's got to go about this right away. This is going to be a very good finish tape, but you know, one or two good shots, and who's to say he's not back in it? Yeah, that's a very good shot. Oh, he probably wanted to be straight on that. That's a sort of skill shot.
Yeah.
I wouldn't advise playing it from here now, but he might not have a choice, to be honest.
No, I know Jason's not. I've seen him play a few skill shots early on, and he didn't get them, to be fair. But like I say, for our game coming out of World Rules, this is we've not had that much time to sort of get these shots on and how you do it and the finer aspects of it, like the Scottish boys, because they've been playing it for 20 odd years. But
I think I've seen the best person I've seen playing him is Simon Ward.
Oh, Simon Ward is a monster, and he's just a potting machine.
Yeah, some of the skill shots he pulled off are just. Yeah. Unreal.
Oh, it's just total confidence, isn't it? But here we go. Yes, he's made it. What a great shot. A little bit unfortunate there, but
I think the yellow is more over the pocket than what I actually thought it was.
Yeah, it was well in the jaws.
Yeah. They're not too bad when they're like that. It's just when they're a little bit off, and if you're playing them off angle, then it's a very hard shot.
Yeah, absolutely. And Jason's a few pots away from getting on these. Nicely.
It's a little bit careless, but he might just roll up behind us.
Yeah, Scott could find himself in a spot of bother here.
He just wants to be careful that he doesn't leave all three reds still clustered, because it won't be the hardest hit.
No, absolutely. And he won't want to give Scotty, he'd want to cut his angles out as much as possible here. He don't want to come up behind the ball and get himself, like you say, with the balls clustered up, and get himself in more trouble.
That's it, because then all Scott has to do is hit one, and Jason's back in the same position. He's a bit knackered.
Such an attacking player, Jason. He's looking for every way out of this. You can be sure of that.
He might even be able to take the ball in the middle and maybe screw into him if he's got enough angle.
Can we see the angle off of a different camera? Not really. It looks caught. Fairly straight. Maybe just coming back to the rail. Yeah. Yeah. Again, options here.
Yeah, this is a shot now, I think. Just roll this up to the top and leave him stuck in behind it. He's got a bit of two cushion escape.
Right on top of this ball, do you think?
Yeah, he might even try and leave him in a little bit of a gap in between the two of them. If he can, then that'll be the shot. Just got to be careful, it's a cushion there.
Yeah, that's his worry. He doesn't want to pop the ball. And he's got to make sure he hits the cushion and not pop the white ball out too far. It's a delicate little shot, this one.
Yeah, it's not the easiest. I mean, if he gets this right, though, it's a frame winner. But
no, is he going off the red just to try and bring it back out?
Yeah, might even be going for the finish here. It looks like he might be playing it off the
red. It would surprise me with Jason, you know.
Yeah, clear. Would have gone, but he might have got an edge of this. No, he hasn't. It's called a total. It's been given.
Yeah, total snooker's called. But I'll tell you what, it's like we said earlier, it's not, you know, they're not the easiest reds, are they? You know.
No, if he does it this, Scott's back in control, you know. And there he is, it? He's back in control. But I think Jason can play another little fine shot off this and leave Scott, but he's got a big target at the top end of the table with the two yellows, so
I think he'll just clip off this one on the rail and leave the white nestled into the reds.
It does help though with the two yellows being together, he's got a big target even if he has to come off more than one cushion.
Well, that's the shot he played, but
it's pretty loose. He wanted to be tight though. He wanted to leave him.
He's still totaled. It's a total snooker again, like you say. Where that plaque is, whether he can come round inside the others, or yeah, he has. Yeah,
he's opened them up, but he's
How well has he come out of that?
Well, that's
he's had his birthdays and Christmas all at once there.
Yeah, that's quite fortunate there, but
I think he's obviously playing around them angles, but to miss that, yeah, there and come into the other two.
That's the thing, though. I think Scott shouldn't really have been left a shot even to see the two cushions
no,
there.
He's far too good, yeah. But anyway, it's a total, so we can run into these.
It's a decent shot. I think Jason's gone favourite for the frame, though, actually.
Unless he can miss that yellow and come behind the other two. And it might be a whole different ball game.
Probably, I think he'll look to try and put the white in the jaws of the pocket here, and try not to leave him too much of a shot. He's left him a long one, but this is going to test him here. It's a big shot for him, this.
Well, let's hope he's had the oil on that elbow, because he's going to need it for this shot.
He might even be looking at playing the safety. He can sort of just drop this and leave the white on the side rail.
Yeah, he could be playing both there, couldn't he? He could still be going for the finish, but also containing. He can get in behind this red. I don't know, might be a bit tight for that. It might be a slow roll, do you think?
Yeah, I think he'll just play the slow roll and play the snooker. It looks like he's going for the pot. He's digging quite deep on it. Now he's covered the block. Yeah, he's played that well.
Clever shot. Played the slow roll, but we didn't say that he was going to put the red by the black. And Jason sees these shots, and he's giving himself a chance.
Big target now, though, as well, for Scott to get a bit of a snooker. Like. Oh, he's opened them. I'm not sure he did play to open them up there. But
That's probably the worst shot he's played in 8 frames, to be honest, or 9 frames. But it's not the end of the world. There's nothing easier. Jason's got his thinking cap on, that's for sure. As you see from the last shot, see what he gets up to there.
Yeah, because by moving this now, he's going to make the black double as well. So if he doesn't get this white quite right, the finish will be on for Scott.
Yeah, Scott's definitely got two balls, one on each side of the table that he can bang in. I mean, he's a great long putter, Scott, as well, and he can play. He plays the ball hard, doesn't he? He's a very confident putter.
I think he's tried to block the straight screw into it there, but yeah, it's a bit of half a chance of Scott, this massive frame in terms of the match.
All day long he's going for this. Imagine if he pulls this finish off to go 7-2, how good is he going to feel after that?
It's a match winner, I think, if he gets these. It's quite a way off there.
Yeah, he felt that, didn't he? It was like you say, it was the game. You know, if he's got this game, he knows the match is at his mercy.
Yeah,
but
I think
still,
because they both had a couple of little half chances in this black frame, I think it's more important to win it. If this goes 6-3, you know, you're going to be kicking yourself like thinking that I had a chance in the last.
Yeah, and that, you know, and things can turn around easily and quickly, can't they? Now then, Craig, what do you think to that?
Not
as planned.
No, it's a bit of a strange one. Scott's but I'll just try and cover the bottom right hand hole now and seize control. It's gone. It's not the best, really. That. You can. He's left Jason a pot here and perfect
take the ball by the horns, couldn't they? Crash into the yellow, red, and black.
I think it's one of them as well. You get the pot, I think. You deserve
a bit
of luck.
You get the pot, you're definitely disturbing. Even kissing the black out, but depending on how much side you put on it, how hard you're going to play it. But he's not being tempted in. Look, he's trying to make sure of this. It's a massive frame, like you say.
I think that's the wrong shot.
Yeah, it's not the shot you'd sort of put Jason up with it. If you was looking at it and saying who's playing Jason, you think he's going for that pot, don't you?
Yeah, all it takes now is one pot from Scott here, and then
he's covered that.
A decent angle.
He's covered that yellow. If he hasn't covered that yellow, he was in trouble. But
well, that's for me another strange choice.
Yeah, a bit harder than you would have thought just to drop into it, but.
Yeah, I really thought of the attack there. I thought he'd just play the cut back to the yellow nearest the ball line.
Yeah, they both made a few mistakes. They're both looking at it thinking, oh, I want to try and make sure of this. You know, I don't want to do anything too stupid too quickly, maybe.
Yeah, but I just thought from where the ball is there for the yellow, I thought he's got a perfect chance to bring it out, you know.
Yeah, I think three or four frames ago, they'd have both gone for that.
I don't think Scott really needs to change anything about the way he's played, you know. I think he should have just carried on in the same vein. He's got the lead.
Definitely. He's got 6-2 playing the way he's got. Well, if that kisses...
He's come out all right.
That's heartbreaking for Jason.
Yeah, it'd been a great shot if they got all right.
That's heartbreaking for Jason. He's had another nightmare.
Another inch or two, he'd have been perfect.
Scott won't be. I don't think he'll be overly troubled with that. He can putt and push this ball, or he can screw in behind it.
Looks like he's
raising on into this. Yeah, that's a shot. See, Scott is a sort of pressure player. He likes the big shot rather than the dollies.
Yeah, he's got two rails now too. It looks like he's playing it one actually.
Yeah, he'll be pushing straight up and down here.
No, it goes in.
And it's. A fairly big pocket for him. It's a little bit short, but that won't bother him.
Yeah, you'd expect him to make this, wouldn't you? Just make sure, if anything.
You can't really see it anymore from that, but there it is.
It's a great shot.
Just off the red, and Scott Higgins goes into a massive 7-2 lead. First to 9 with the break.
Huge frame that was.
Absolutely huge frame. Jason was, I think they were both a little bit negative there, Craig, didn't you?
Yeah, I thought they both had a couple of opportunities to attack light, but, you know, it paid off well for Scott.
Yeah, it did. I was surprised Jason didn't take the cut on to crash into the two balls or just pop into them, but at the end of the day, he's done what he thought right. It's not come off for him. Scott 7-2, looking at a break to go 8-2.
Yeah, I can't see him getting beat from here. It really needs to. He'd need to seize up, wouldn't he, really? I think even if Jason played at his best, he's going to struggle to beat him 7-1 from here.
Jason playing at his best, Scott's going to get a couple of frames here, but no matter what you think. Let's see what happens with the break. Oh.
Well.
Again,
just one ball
tied up a little bit. I don't think he's got the angle here, even playing off the red to open it, but...
I think the red might actually go into the middle, you know. It might pot. If it does pot, then it makes things a little bit easier. At least he can drop onto it. But if not, it'll be a tough finish, this.
Well, he'll be working out his roadmap now. He's not going to be playing safe from here. It's a
table you want to be attacking, don't you? But it's just a little bit awkward. Like, there's a couple of decent shots you're going to have to...
Yeah.
He's going to go yellows.
Yeah, he's going to go yellows. And he'll be banging this in. Be no dollying around here. He'll be banging this in, trying to get himself set up for a nice finish. No, he's pushing it through. Now he's changed his shot. That's good.
Perfect angle now to run into it. Yeah, get one. This one good cannon now. And
options again, Craig. Yeah.
Yeah, I think he just runs into it and he's perfect, isn't he?
He runs into this gap now. He doesn't really want to run behind them. If he runs into the yellow or even into the red, he's missed the yellow.
I don't think he needs to play that hard there. I thought he could have just played it at like a normal pace. But
very surprised. I think it was thin enough just to be able to go up. I think he's tried to push it through his side off the rail to pop it out rather than just to go into the cluster, you know?
Yes, I'm surprised he's missed that. He just looks like he's tensed up a little bit. It's in the winning line a bit, I think. It's a bit of a, I don't know. He's playing really well early doors, and now he's just made a couple of little mistakes. And
yeah, he's let his arm go a little bit there. I don't think he needed to do that, and if that plant's anywhere near on.
I think if it weren't on, I think he'd be going into it now, wouldn't
he? Yeah, if that's on, this is a great chance for Jason just to...
It's a good shot as well, he's got an angle now.
Steady the boat and get another frame on the board. And that's all he can do at the moment, one at a time, and just try and claw it back as well as he can.
Yeah, I mean, if Scott keeps making mistakes like the last couple of frames, I think Jason will take a bit of heart from it, and I think Scott will be kicking himself, you know, so there could be a way back into it for him. But he needs Scott to make mistakes, really. He can't. It's not just going to be about him, you know. It's going to be about Scott making a little...
Oh, absolutely. I mean, we keep talking about Jason's experience in the game and what he's accomplished, and that's what he'll be looking at now, is just waiting for Scott to make the mistakes, let him crawl back in, try and put a bit of pressure on him.
I remember in when he got to one of the world finals, when he played Potts, I think he was 8-2 down to Gareth Hibbert in a first 7-2 down to Hibbert first to 9. And he ended up clawing back and winning it, like, because obviously Gareth had never been to a world final, so
yeah,
he's always going to be a master.
His experience, yeah. And look at Gareth now, he's the IPA number one.
Yeah, he's playing well this year.
A wealth of experience. And another guy, like you say, that's playing absolutely out of his socks this season.
But again, though, he played in the last 64 before, and he was giving a real scare off John-Joe Sharkey, and, like, one of the up-and-coming amateurs. And
absolutely. Another new guy that's come through, and a great player he is. You see Jason now just pop that red into the middle, leaving himself the simplest blacks to go 7-3 with the break.
That's the one thing that has impressed me about this tour. The standard of the amateur game is top draw.
I thought he was going to say the standard of the tables, Craig.
Yeah, they're top draw as well. You know, they're better than any tour I've played on.
Yeah, brilliant Supreme tables. All the top players love the Supreme tables. They're
superb, aren't they?
By far the best tables out there.
They're so fast as well. I don't think I've been to many comps where the tables have been anywhere near as fast. You know,
no, got three guys out there all the time brushing and ironing them after every match, making sure that it's the best that we can do for these players. You want the best equipment for the best players, don't you?
Yeah, definitely. It gets the best out of them, doesn't it?
Here we go. Hold on tight. The Tornado is about to get his best break yet. No. Yes. He's made it. He's kept the white out. He's made a ball.
If you can see that one to the middle now.
That's 100% improvement on the rest of his breaks, isn't it?
Yeah, that's massive, yeah. At least he's getting first go at him, you know, it's this massive part of the game. So I think that's all he asked for, isn't it? He asked for a ball and you want to be in control.
Absolutely, and if he can see his way through to get this first red.
You'd fancy him running out, but...
All day long.
If he can't get through to that, then it's a question of where is the first red going to come from.
It does look a bit tricky, doesn't it? It looks all a little bit... It's happened so many times, you get a great break and all of a sudden it's just a little bit tricky from everywhere. One mistake here, and you know you give the frame away. So
yeah,
massive shot. He's got to get it right.
He can't get through to the ball in the middle, so he's going to have to play something good here. I think it's going to be some sort of safety, containing safety.
Yeah, it's a shame, but it's all he could do. I mean, he's done the right thing. You know, he's got to sit back and he's got to say, look, you know, the white hasn't gone in. I've made the break. It's not come out right. Got to try and hold back.
But at least you're not giving the control over to Scott. You know, it's in your hands, isn't it?
So that's it, Craig. Trying to force the mistake. That's all he can do. And you can see it in Scott's face here. He's looking at making this red. he's looking at making his red in the other corner, I think. And just stamping his authority on the game again.
This is probably frame ball as well. Yeah, he's made that. That's a great shot. That'll probably
that's
win
fine,
the frame.
That's fine. That's great. He's played it well. He hasn't, you know, he's put his elbow away again. He's not gone bad.
That's it. He just needs to just compose himself now and take the lead. And then he'll be looking at getting on the hill.
Angry kid has just calmed down, I think. He's got his ball to the middle pocket now. Great
he's
shot.
Spitting image of the angry kid, isn't he?
Angry kid he is. You know when he's losing because he's all red. His colour's coming back now. He knows this is prime position and opportunity to go on the hill.
Yeah, he's played really well throughout the match. I mean, just probably one or two little shots, but you know, apart from that, he's been really solid and not making mistakes. Not really missing balls either, so yeah, it's been a good standard.
No, he doesn't miss any, and it has been a good standard. Although there's, there's a big score difference. It's been great to watch, though, you know. And
probably
it's not over.
No, the break's probably caused the score difference as well. That's the biggest thing, you know. Scott's broke well, and Jason's just like lost the white. I mean, when you lose a white against the top boys and you're giving him a free shot, you expect not to get back to the table.
Yeah, Jason's had a mare with the break, hasn't he? And it's. You know, it's heartbreaking, isn't it? It's so big. The break is so massive. When it comes to get you know what it's like. You can play all day and all night and pot a ball off the break every time. Then you can play all day and all night another day and not get anything and throw the white around every time, you know. And the more it happens, the more you're trying to force it. And
yeah,
that's and things can go wrong.
That's probably when it starts going more wrong. It's just...
Oh!
It's creeped in there. It's wiping its feet.
He's played it well enough. Good enough speed.
Give you a little shot of the arena.
There we go. See the lads in the background.
All the tables are busy playing away in the last 64 of the open event.
I think I can just see Gareth Hibbert. Talking about Gareth Hibbert earlier, he's out there playing on table 10 or 11, I think. I think the winner of that game, who's he playing? Pickering?
Yeah. Is he playing Pick? Alright, no, that's not Pick.
Who's he playing? Can't see. But is I think this is the winners play each other, do they? And that'd be a great match. There you go, Scott has got that frame and he's jumped into an 8-4 lead over Jason Twiss. Scott Higgins on the hill with the break to take the match.
I'd be looking to set his own now, won't he, as soon as possible. Sometimes yeah, you can just get a bit complacent, you know, and just you probably want to get back up to his hotel room and get a bit of rest as soon as possible. It's a bit of a tough schedule, isn't it, you know, when you're playing, if you're in everything.
Yeah, well, interestingly enough, I know in the last two games in the open event, Jason won his and Scott won his. They actually meet again after this match in the tour event. So there's obviously going to be a bit of backbiting going on there.
Yeah,
but
it's
two great lads and I'm sure they'd enjoy it.
I think if it does finish 9-3 as well, it's a weird one as how you go about the next match.
It's gone dry.
These yellows are flopping.
It's gone
well.
Dry. And as we say in the poor world, almost dollies.
Yeah, these. If the yellow goes between the gap, then you can't see him missing these. But you think it's probably just delaying the inevitable, don't you?
Oh yeah, absolutely. I mean, it's not just uphill this now for Jason. It's almost vertical. It's a very, very tricky game to get out, match to get out of now. But you know Jason as well as I do. He's a proper fighter. You talk about players that are fighting and players that give up. He's not the latter at all. He will be 100% on this.
Yeah, stranger things have happened. It's not impossible for him to win six frames in a row against Scott. You know, it will happen at some point. So why not now?
Absolutely. And another great little controlled shot there. He's come between the red and the yellow and he's just landed on this yellow, but I think there's enough room just to sneak through here. Yeah,
he can screw this back, he'll be fine as long as he gets past the middle pocket. See a bit of tension in his arm there.
Yeah, a little bit of bad timing there. It's the old needs to get the oil in the elbow again. It's just tightened up a bit, but and that's not great, to be honest.
I think he'll look at playing the cut here into the top left hand corner.
I think you're right, drifting it in.
Yeah. course,
and give himself a chance to.
That's the tricky. It's not,
get
it's
back.
Not the easiest part, you know, especially he's just tensed up in the last one.
This will show how well he's carrying now. Great shot. It's a great shot.
Yeah, and he's on his awkward ball as well. He can. It's just preference now. Which way you want to go about? Which way you want to go about it?
A little bit of a tricky angle. He might be looking at just.
He could use the rather as a stopper.
Or even screwing off it, but we'll see. We'll see. It's how he feels. These guys, they like to play it positively, don't they? Rather than give themselves a chance to make a complete fluff. But
it's that thing as well. People, if you look for something to go wrong, you know it probably will.
Yeah, absolutely.
Massive part of the game. If you get down, you think the ball's going in, and you truly believe it, then more often than not, it will do.
And obviously, his easiest shot is the one at the top table, but he's looking down at taking one of the two balls there to make it an easier finish, because it can go wrong. But again, strong player, you know, strong-minded. If he sees this as being the right shot, you know, for sure, Jason will take it. But
I think I'd just bump into this and try and leave it the white exactly where the red is. If he plays the other way, he's going to be doing quite a bit of travelling with the white ball, so it'll be a case of if he does play this way, it's going to be one good shot. But with this, he's going to have to do a little bit of travelling.
Just a little pop out. Yeah, that's good.
See, now he's
overhit it.
He's faced with the same sort of dilemma now. A bit of travelling now.
Yeah.
I think he can go. It looks like he can go two rails past the block, or he might just play the one cushion screw shot.
A little bit of reverse side on there, and could have done with going a bit further. That I think he's got almost the same angles he had to start with, has he not?
Yeah, now he's going to have to leave like the same shot on the block, isn't he? So, but at least only one thing on the block. He's just got to pop the ball.
He's got to screw into this red and use it to pop down the table. Oh no, he's tried to get. Oh, that's a great shot. How well has he played that?
Yeah, that's an awesome shot.
He's played that right. I think I would have screwed into the red, and
that could have gone wrong.
Yeah, that was a great shot. Great strength of mind there from the top player.
It's worked
for him. He's made it 8-4, and he's going to be very, very happy with that. That's going to give him a little bit of a boost, isn't it? Because he's played that quite well. To be fair,
he's going to need a few. He's going to probably need a few more finishes from the bright light, but. You know, if he can just get back to 8-6, 8-7, just put a little bit of pressure on Scott, it'll put a bit of doubt in his mind, you know.
Let's see if his break's held up. He had a good break last time. He was a bit unfortunate with the way the white landed and the way the ball's landed. He had to play safe, but will he succeed in another good break? Only time will tell. 8-4, Scott Higgins.
I'm going to go for the scratch.
You're a nasty man. That's bad karma, that is. I'm going to go for three balls down, and the white absolutely plumb, and the yellow's dollies.
That's got a feeling. Well, Jason here breaking, trying to get back into the match. Open for a decent break. Needs to just put a big run together now. He needs to really find his best form. Well, you're all right, Carl.
I'll tell you what, I've called it. Apart from myself, how many balls has he got down? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Yeah, he's got three balls down on the white plum.
Three balls down, white plum, and the yellow's dollies.
Yeah, Mystic Meg is.
Mystic Carlos.
Yeah, she's going to lose her job, isn't she?
Tell you what, that was a great break.
You don't have tonight's lottery numbers as well, do you?
Somebody's already won Euro Millions. We're still here.
Ah, well.
We're not jetting off. No, that's just what Jason needed, wasn't it? It's
it's the routine.
The best break of the day for him, best break of the match, rather, for sure.
Just needs quick frame, just get right back into this match, you know, and just put a bit of doubt in Scott's head.
Needs to flow. But Scott's going to be sitting there thinking,
one chance.
Yeah, no, that's all I need. One good chance to get to the table.
You think he will get it at some point, won't you?
Yeah, for sure. He's got the break next frame.
play this into the internal pocket now and then play the one over the hole, leave an angle and look for the one at the bottom table. It's all pretty straightforward, to be honest.
So, here he goes. Last but one ball, stun it straight down the table.
Just wants to avoid being, yeah, he's still okay. It's a little bit closer to cushion, but...
It's not perfect, but I think he'll plop this in for the black in the middle, do you think?
Yeah, or maybe over the top.
Yeah. There it is. Easiest of blacks to the middle pocket. Jason Twist. Pulls back another one. 8-5.
He's back alive again after a couple of quick frames from Jason.
Yeah, it's looking a whole different game, isn't it? It's like it was all of a sudden, you know, it was the Scott Higgins picture show, and now all of a sudden it's the Jason Twist game, you know.
Still needs a lot from here, but you never know, a couple of dry breaks from Scott and there's no reason why he couldn't run four on the trot. So
Scott'll be racking his balls up now going, give me a good break. Give me dollies like he just had.
Yeah, but that's the sort of chance.
He's had his dollies, he's had his good breaks, hasn't he? So it's not like he hasn't had them, so there's no reason why he can't get another one here.
Yeah, I'd just be asking for a ball, anything. If he can just get control of the frame, he'd be happy.
One chance, that's what he's looking for.
Get himself a semi-final spot. Oh, he's gone off.
Get the black in, he wants the black in. No, he hasn't gone in.
Wow, so... The match is turning around there.
Everything has turned around a full circle. Scott Higgins is going in off the break, leaving the balls everywhere. Jason Twist is breaking like God. 8-5. Can you see this going away at all, Craig? Can you see it? Go on, tell me. Can you see it happening?
Yeah, I can, to be honest with you.
You can see it happening, can't you? You wouldn't put it past him, would you?
Yeah, it's like you say, it's really turned on its head. It looked like Scott was miles clear at like 8-3, but you know, Jason got a couple of quick frames, and if he gets this one here, there'll be a bit of doubt in Scott's mind, you know. It's having such a big lead and someone clawing back at you, it can't be the easiest thing. I wouldn't know because I don't get many big leads.
You don't need big leads, you just win.
I try and keep it close. But there's no reason why Jason can't at least, maybe not win the match, but like at least pressure him, you know, just make him feel like he's been in a match.
Oh yeah, Jason will be doing everything to try and make Scott bleed here. He's not going to give this up without a fight, as we said earlier. You know, I mean, he's looking at 6-7 frames behind earlier, and now he's within 3, and if he can take this out with his free shot and his free ball, you know, he's within 2. And one of them two is going to get a break, and it's going to be the next one to come. You know, you can look at this now and say a good dish for 8-6 and a break and dish 8-7.
It might be 8-7 and Scott's not been to the table for 4 frames, and all of a sudden, you know, you've been sat in your chair for a while, especially if it takes a while over this finish. You know, you've been sat there for quite some time, and then it becomes hard again. You know you're in a match. You know, you won the look first of 2 then, and you've not had a shot for a while, and the other guy's not missing.
Yeah, it's a mad game sometimes, isn't it? But you can see it. Jason's got to be thinking now. He probably fancies this now, you know?
Yeah.
He probably fancies this game. You know, a few frames ago, he's got to be thinking, just hang on to his tails. But now, he fancies it.
Yeah, you've probably just got to get this frame, and then just go, why not? Why could I not win from here? Balls are in decent enough positions to attack here, so if he does get these, it's game on again.
Absolutely.
I don't know if anyone out there on the chat for the stream has any predictions of who's going to win the main event over the weekend. If you do, we'd love to hear them. Who would you go with, Cole?
Well, if Jason pulls this off, I'm going to go with him.
Yeah, it would give him confidence for the rest of the weekend, wouldn't it?
So Jason's still in it, Scott's still in it, Gareth Ibbett's still in it. You've got a few of the Welsh boys.
I know Marshy plays. Dave McNamara tonight.
McNamara, another great player, played him in the Worlds.
Yeah, he's a good player.
You know,
he's an honourable man, but he's a good player.
There's a lot of great players out there, like you're saying, and there's a lot of great players still in, you know, still in there. I mean, it is wide open, isn't it? You know.
Yeah, there's so many good players. It's hard to. Neil Raybone's still batting, who won the last one. I think Lee Anderson's still in the. I think he's through to the quarterfinals or semis. You beat Neil Raybone before.
Yeah, I think there's another new player he's got in that as well. I'm not sure who it is, but it's.
Yeah, Lee. I think Lee will play the winner of Gareth Ibbett and Mark Pickworth, which is at the minute it's Mark Pickworth leading 6-3, which. It's a tad of a surprise, you know. I think most people would have fancied Gareth to win that match, but just shows the standard, you know. Someone ranked 20-odd in the pros is giving, you know, the number one seed a bit of a fright.
Absolutely, and it's, like I say, it's open. There's a lot of players out there. We're just looking at all the new games going on now. It's in the amateur. Have a little look at the background there. You see all the new players coming on now, playing in this group stage format. It's a great format, guarantees everybody gets lots of frames, value for money this tour. As it was before, you could lose a few, two matches and be out and your money's spent, but that's so unlucky.
Oh, he's been lucky though as well, because he's tied the red.
He's played one. See, he's got into the position now where he's come back to the game and he's got his confidence back and he's gone for the shots that he would have gone for before. But at the end of the day, you know, he's let Scott in.
Yeah, Scott's got a good chance here, but he's still got to play. You know, a very very good shot to get the.
He's got to keep his head on, hasn't he?
Yeah. A decent shot by Scott there. He's got a couple of balls on cushions now, but
yeah, you're not seeing an easy run out here, are you? It's
no, he's gonna do well to take these. Gareth Ibbett now is 7-3 down on one of the other tables in the quarter final. So Lee Anderson could be playing Mark Pickworth for both of them, a chance to make the first pro event final.
There you go, exciting times for these players.
Oh, that's gone wrong. It's
well,
Scott's just gone massive favourite now for the.
Are we looking at a 9-5?
Yeah, I think he just play this containing safety.
He couldn't do a lot there apart from that.
Puts it in Scott's hands now, where he can take the long ball here. Pots this, he's got a perfect angle to run into the three balls and then have a good chance to take the match.
Just got to get his head on here. I think he's going safe. Yeah,
that's played safe.
That's a great shot. He's played that really well, to be honest.
I'm not sure if he's left the ball next to the block here. If he has, it's pretty cool, is that?
I don't think so. I don't know.
It's quite hard to tell from where he's at.
That's
I'll just try and cover the ball.
Trying
back
to
now.
Pop it back in. Oh.
That's alright.
Well. He's played a little defending shot there. I think he's giving Scott the chance to go here, you know. Whether he fancies going for it or whether he fancies taking this, getting up the table and tying it up again, we'll soon find out.
Yeah, I think he... I think he can play the long ball here and just actually go into the two. He's got a perfect angle just to go run off two rails, but it's whether you fancy playing such a shot at this time, you know. You can play it off one cushion as well, but the black going in could be a danger.
I can see you coming off this here, hitting the black, going off the yellow and going in the middle pocket and feeling like an absolute plonker.
Yeah, he's made sure he didn't do that, hasn't he?
Yeah, he's played thin for the... He's played wide for the red. He's missed it, but he's still in control.
There's a possibility of playing the red off the yellow, I think, and... I think it might go in off the yellow, but or am I just being...
that is an option, but he's also got the option of pushing this red through and putting the white up behind the other.
Yeah, or he could just play the long pot and leave the angle. He's got a few options here.
Yeah, he's gone well wide. Oh, it's not dropped. It was almost disasters.
I think Jason would take that before that shot.
Let's
play the plant now, and you can just play with a trace aside and actually run into it. You know, just I'm not even sure he needs to run into it.
I don't think he needs to run into it myself. You know, Craig, I think he can just play this plant, plop it out.
It's one of them, though. I think the angle's just he's got a bit too much angle. I think he might struggle to hold for that, so he might be just best just like running.
Scott Higgins won't be happy with that. He knows that was a prime time for him to take the match out.
Into it and he's come out.
He's avoided the in off. Is he on the draw? Can he see the ball?
Yeah, he can see that. He's alright.
It's not guaranteed to get on this last yellow, you know.
Yeah, I think he's alright. I think he just plays the
twitchy
one.
Twitchy time this. One mistake.
He's got to leave
he's
a long
packing
one
his in. Bags, isn't he?
He's got to leave. Ooh, maybe it's close. If he can't see this ball over the hole here, he's just going to have one good long shot and it's back in the match, you know. He's got to be kicking himself.
There, but yeah, you can obviously see it, Jason. Screw back side into the red.
Yeah, he's perfect. And
he's landed Peter there, hasn't he?
He's
going to be happy with that.
Swung. He's going to think, oh, let's put your arm through this and just make sure you cue it straight. Ah, it's there. That's great cueing.
There you go. Wealth of experience from Jason Twist.
You can see there how pleased he was with it. He got straight down to the black.
And unbelievably, this game's gone 8-6.
That's massive, because Scott's had a chance there to win the match. If Jason does win this frame, he'll be kicking himself a little bit, you know. 8-7, you think. I should have been like, should have been back in my room chilling out.
Without a doubt, you could see the light at the end of the tunnel there. And Jason's got a chance. If he gets one of those dolly breaks again, what's your prediction for this break, Craig? What have we got?
To be honest, I can't see him not making a ball.
No,
I feel like the tide's turning.
No, it's absolutely, it's all running Jason's way again now. It's he's got momentum, you know.
No, I've said that though. Probably he probably will go in off or something.
I'm not going for the three balls with the dolly white and the dolly yellows this time. I think he's going to struggle. He's going to make one ball. And he's going to have a struggle. I think this could be a to and fro game, this one. Seen it in the stars, but only time will tell. Oh, he's avoided the in off.
The yellows look nice. They just got that one ball on the bottom rail.
He struggled to make the one ball, like I said, but he didn't in fact make any. So Scott has got a chance here with yellows.
He's just got to stay composed there. He'd
walk around the table a few times, get his head together.
It's probably a 50-50 finish for him, but I think in practice he'd be taking this 80% of the time. You know, he's just got to stay focused. And
it's obviously a whole different ball game now. He's on the live streaming TV. He knows he's got one chance here to take the frame away and stop the tornado in his tracks. He don't want him to get to the table again, that's for sure.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, this is the province now wide open, you know, especially if Gareth gets beat, it's there for the taking, this. Definitely, there's no reason why the winner of this match can't win the tournament.
No, absolutely. We've said it before, and you can see one of these winning it all day long.
Just joined now by Lee Anderson, who's through to the semis of the province.
Well done, Lee Anderson. Who have you got the winner off? So we've heard that Mark's playing Gareth, and in fact, Gareth's down 7-6. Lee Anderson gets the winner of that game. Meanwhile, Scotty has not played the greatest shot there. His elbow stiffened up on him a little bit there, but he's still at the table. He's still got chances, and he'll be fighting to get this frame out to take the match. That's a great shot, Scott Higgins. He's played that so well. After the last shot where he was a little bit edgy, he's now left himself a nice shot to the middle to leave himself a nice shot to the corner, and a nice shot to the middle of the corner to get up the top for the last ball and claim this match.
Yeah, it looks good to take the match here. But again, if somehow it does go wrong, you know, Jason's...
Oh, he's had a nightmare.
He's all right, he can just drop this in.
He's not got into that at all, has he?
Nah, he's bridging.
He's got long fingers though, Scott. I know he's got long fingers because he keeps managing to steal my cigarettes out of my jeans pocket when I'm not looking. Yeah, there you can see him queuing over miles above that ball. And in it goes, and he looks to have a real good angle here, Craig.
Yeah, he won't get a better chance than this to take the match. He's got to watch
the off. Jason's just sitting there now thinking, am I going to get back to the table? He's had a great fight back here, Jason, you know. I mean, he's almost tipped the scales into his favour. And in it goes, that's a great shot.
He's going to be facing a long block now, though.
He is. He won't be doing a lot with this yellow because
he's
not got the greatest angle, and like you say, don't need to. He can go on to his wealth of experience, pop this shell up, get his head on, and slot the black in to claim the match.
This would hurt if he didn't take this chance, though. It'd be one of them. It would be one that could potentially give the match to Jason.
Yeah, I mean, it's a big ball, isn't it, really? I mean, like you say, you can... It potentially, 8-7... It's horrible for Scott Higgins.
Especially after the... Oh.
He's left it absolutely perfect.
Dead straight. Just got to get your head down, stay down on the shot and just cue through the ball.
Time to breathe, Scott. Cue up, approach the table. Line it up. And slot it in for the match. What a great shot by Scott Higgins there, beating Jason Twist 9-6. It's a great comeback from Jason Twist, but Scott's held on. So from Craig and Carlos, thanks very much. Next game will be coming on soon.
Golden.